Test you.
Like a lone ranger, not a stranger. I ain't scared of danger. My savior was born in a manger. Nappy head driver, that's me. Uncle Nappy, deliver the mail so you won't go to hell.
Nappy head prophet.
Oh yeah, nappy head driver. You can't tell me to stop.
In the eyes, and you say, well, who did this? Who opened the door? Who took this out? Who broke this? And they look at you and say, it ain't my fault. Come on now, hallelujah. Oh my God, you got people, grown people saying, it ain't my fault, hallelujah. Oh, they're going around robbing, stealing, killing, and blaming. Well, I didn't have no daddy, I didn't have no mom. In essence, it ain't my fault. Come on now. Oh my God, hallelujah. Then wars have been started, in wars, 4,000 bodies, praise God, and somebody's still saying, it ain't my fault. They may not use those exact words, but sometimes your actions, come on now, sometimes the words you use, hallelujah, fall in line with it ain't my fault. Come on now, hallelujah. Oh my God, hallelujah. You lose a ball game, start fighting, fussing and everything, and then when it all comes down, you say, well, it ain't my fault. You blame it on the coach. Come on now. What it ain't my fault means is that you're not taking the responsibility for what you're doing, praise God. Instead of taking the responsibility, you cop out by saying it ain't my fault. Oh my God, hallelujah. In a gang because I didn't have a daddy and mama didn't let me have my way, so it ain't my fault. Come on now, hallelujah. Well, whose fault is it? Come on now. Oh my God, two of you all go to bed. Come on, man. A boy and a girl go to bed. The girl end up pregnant. The boy, first thing the boy said, ain't my fault, huh? She said, ain't my fault. Well, it's somebody's fault. Something happened, praise God. And it is a fault, because if you did it outside of marriage, it was a fault, praise God. Oh my God, see, so you know the message is, it ain't my fault. Come on now. Oh, God is tired of all this copping out. Even preachers got that attitude, it ain't my fault. Long as they get your money and whatever's going on with you, well, it ain't my fault, because you didn't, evidently you didn't listen. Well, finances ain't gonna get me away from this crazy person in my life. Come on now. Finances ain't gonna keep, hallelujah, the drug dealer from knocking at the door. Come on now. Oh my God, it is your fault, praise God. If you're not preaching the word of God, if you're not ministering to the homes, praise God, it is your fault. But I know you have this attitude, well, I'm doing my thing and it ain't my fault. Oh my God, hallelujah. Well, praise God, hallelujah. Let's go to Genesis, the third chapter, praise God. Let's go to the 10th verse, and he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. Now, this is Adam talking, praise God, when God said, where are you? Hallelujah. And the 11th verse says, and he said, who told thee that thou was naked? Has thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? And the man said, the woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, what is it thou hast done? And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. See, they all blaming it on somebody, but that it just came clean, hallelujah, and said, Lord, it was me. I messed up. I got deceived. Oh, people that are killing, stealing, and robbing, raping. Come on now. Oh, it's your fault, praise God. You can blame it on your childhood if you want to. You can blame it on this and blame it on that, but you pulled the trigger. Come on now. Oh my God, the devil might have deceived you, may have talked to you, but see, you are at fault, praise God. See, anytime you allow things to go on, praise God, all you got to do is look in the word of God, and the word of God will correct you. It'll check you before you even do it, if you get in the word. But now, if you don't get in the word and you're doing things in contrary, it's your fault, praise God. But you'll still turn around and look at God and say, it ain't my fault, praise God. That's what Adam did. Come on now. He walked with God daily. He heard what God said. Come on now. Hallelujah. If you go into the 11th verse, he said, who told thou that thou was naked? Come on now. And if you go into the 12th verse, he said, the woman who gave it, thou gavest to be with me, and gave me of the tree. She gave me of the tree, and I did eat. Let me tell you something. The Bible says the head is accountable for the household. It doesn't matter what my wife do, praise God. I got to answer to God. Hallelujah. So in order for me to keep from getting chastised and hallelujah beat down by God, so to speak, then I got to make sure everything is running right. I got to make sure the ship is tight and right, praise God. And there are no holes. I can't let the devil in, because I can't let the devil in and talk about it ain't my fault. When God has given me authority, he's given me power up over the devil, praise God. Oh my God, but you still hear people talking about it ain't my fault. Come on now. Oh my God, hallelujah. You didn't have five babies, girl. Hallelujah. You tell me it ain't your fault and you ain't married. Oh my God, it is your fault. And you need to accept your responsibility and be accountable. Oh my God, and cry out to God and ask him to heal you and deliver you and don't have another one, praise God. Oh my God, wait on the Lord. See, when we get impatient, we will fall into fault, praise God. Oh my God, and then to default. Hallelujah. Because see, the longer you go without coming clean with God, you're going into default with God. Oh my God, and then you're going to really have to repent. You're going to have to really cry out. Oh my God, but people are still sinning in this hour. It ain't my fault. The homosexuals say, well, I was born that way. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Oh my God, say, well, I was molested. Oh, when I got raped as a child. Well, you got to understand, I went to prison. But what does the word say? Come on now. Oh, if you cry out to him right now, come on now. Yeah, that may have been somebody else did this. But now, if you can understand, if you can hear the words of my voice, then you need to know that now is the time you need to repent so it can stop being your fault, praise God. You can stand up and be the man of God that you was called to be. God ain't called no homosexual. Come on now. Oh my God, he called men of God, men of valor, men of strength. Come on now. And I'm not talking about physical. I'm talking about spiritual strength. And you can't have no spiritual strength being a homosexual. That is your fault. Come on now. Hallelujah. Let's go to Romans 14. For it is written, as I live, said the Lord, every knee shall bow to me and every tongue shall confess to God. So then shall every one of us shall give account of himself to God. You can't go to God talking about it ain't my fault, God. Oh, I didn't know. It's Bibles everywhere. Come on now. You can get a Bible when you can't get nothing to eat. You can get a Bible when you can't get a gallon of gas. Oh, so there's no excuse. Thou art inexcusable. Oh, my God, oh, wretch man. Come on now. Oh, wretch woman. Come on. You inexcusable. You know what you're doing when you stand up in front of that man. Hallelujah, with your cleavage showing and he's right there with his wife. You know what you're doing when you're batting your eyes, you're winking. Come on now. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. You need to see what the Bible says about the wink of the eye. It's evil behind that. Come on now. Oh my God, it's deception behind it. Hallelujah. So stop saying it ain't my fault. Oh, and your husband wanted to go with me anyway. Well, you the one threw it like that. And if he went with you, it's both of y'all's fault. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh my God, hallelujah. It ain't my fault. Come on now. Oh, that ain't gonna work with God. When you give account of God, you got to come clean with God. You need to start working on that now. Instead of saying, well, it ain't my fault. I didn't know. You're given a Bible. There's Bibles everywhere from Genesis to Revelation. Everything. They call it the book of life. It's the book of truth. It's the book of help. It's everything you need, praise God. And it will create what you desire if you allow God to work through you. If you allow God to work in you. But you got to come clean and quit talking about it ain't your fault, young man. Oh, my God. Oh, it's the white man. It's the white man. This is the white man. That's the reason why I can't get no job. No, you can't get no job because you won't accept responsibility that it is not his fault, praise God. It's your fault because his job's all over the world, praise God. His education all over the world. Young people, come clean. Quit talking about it ain't your fault you can't go to college. You can go to college online, praise God. It is your fault, praise God. But you still sit up and say, well, it ain't my fault. It ain't my fault. Come on now, hallelujah. I got to rap for a living because I got to eat. Come on now, ain't the only way you can eat. You ain't got to sell your soul to eat. Oh my God, hallelujah. When Jesus took two fish and five loaves and fed 5,000 people, and you telling me you got to sell your soul? Come on, sister, you got to get out there and sell your body. Talk about, it ain't my fault, it's the cards that was dealt to me. Well, you ain't got no business playing no cards anyway, praise God. What you got to do is get in the word of God. What you got to do is obey God. Because let me tell you something, you can sit up and say, it ain't my fault. That spirit will take a hold of you, and you use that excuse the rest of your life. But when you come before the throne of God, you've got to give account, praise God, and God ain't trying to hear that. Hallelujah. Let's go to James 5 and 16. Confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. See, when you confess your faults, now he wouldn't tell you to confess your faults if you didn't have faults. Come on now. Hallelujah. Oh my God, you should use a little common sense on that one. one to another, but you gotta be careful of who you're confessing your fault to. Oh my God, cause see when CNN get a hold to it, when TNN get a hold to it, or when the news get a hold to it, they gon' twist it all around. So you got to use wisdom in who you're confessing your fault to. But he said that you may be healed, cause see, once you get that junk out, once you come clean that it was you, oh Lord, it was me. David said, against thee, oh Lord, have I sinned, and thee only. Oh, there comes a cleansing that comes after that, because God is receiving that, cause he know what you did, and you come clean about what you did, then God can heal you, deliver you, and then your prayer will be effectual and fervent, and it will reach the throne of God, and he will move on your behalf. Why? Because you came clean. Why? Because it's my fault, Lord. Oh my God, what I did is my fault. I can't blame nobody for the 19 years I was on drugs. That was my fault, praise God. Oh, I made that choice and that move, praise God. Oh my God, hallelujah. Oh, it is your fault, praise God. But you still want to say it ain't my fault. You're at church every Sunday. Come on now. Oh, cussing people out, talking about it ain't my fault. They made me cuss them out. Oh my God, you better wake up, praise God. But I'm here to tell you, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, I'm going to tell you this right now. If you don't get in that word, if you don't give your life to Christ, praise God, if you go to hell, it ain't my fault.